Hello, it's Andrea here. Got another video from you, and I'm still on the Gnome desktop. With my favourite menu, which is the Windows style start menu. And last time I focused on, you know, told you about various customization options that you can do with Gnome. I'm running Linux Mint 21.2. There is a later version, 21.3, but I'm not running that yet. I'm running this with the Ubuntu Gnome desktop. Well, it is. Sure enough, look. And I've got the GNOME extension, the Arc menu, which gives you the Windows style start menu. And when you install a GNOME desktop, you have to install GNOME Shell Extensions in order to get the full functions, like the customizations, and also to be able to have certain add-ons. And when you install GNOME Shell Extensions, the Ubuntu desktop and the GNOME desktop does have different login options. There's a Wayland session, and there's a Ubuntu on Zorg, and there's also a Gnome Classic logging. There's a Gnome Classic login option, and a Gnome Flashback login option. And I want to show those they're not different desktop environments, they're the same, but they're all part of the Gnome desktop, although Gnome Flashback can be run as a separate desktop environment. And so that's what I'm going to show you now. So I'm going to log out of Gnome desktop. And show you that now. Yeah, so this is what I'm trying to explain. See, this is the logon screen, and on the logon screen, you see you've got all these different options. You've got like the Ubuntu desktop where I was logged into, where I just showed you. And you've got GNOME Classic. You've got GNOME on Zorg. And then you've got Ubuntu on Wayland, Ubuntu on Zorg, and you've also got GNOME Flashback, all these different logins. The GNOME Classic is with, it's part of the GNOME Shell Extensions. If I can bring it closer to the screen, I don't know if you can actually see the different logins. Look. There they are. Ubuntu. See, I mean, this is like the end of Display Manager, but I don't know why it's displaying them as duplicates. It's the same. I mean, I've got two Display Managers. One's GDM and one's Light DM. I prefer Light DM. This is Light DM GTK Greeter, but you know. So you got the Ubuntu desktop here, and you've got, there's a Wayland session. I think you can see that here. And you've also got Gnome Flashback Metacity, which is the window manager that comes with it, unless you've installed Compiz, and then there'll be a Gnome Flashback Compiz. But when you install Gnome Shell Extensions, it's not a different desktop, it's just part of Gnome Shell Extensions. I'll show you what I mean. I'll log into it, and then you can actually see for yourself that it's interesting, the different options that you do get with Gnome, you know. So it's like, I'm going to log into Gnome Flashback. So I'm on the Gnome Flashback desktop now, and Linux Mint. Well, it says Gnome, but it is Gnome Flashback, and you've got two panels. You've got a bottom panel, which, you know, this is simple screen recorder, which is what I'm using to record this. I also use Kazam, but it doesn't seem to work very well in Gnome Flashback, but there you go. This is the menu with all your applications. It's easy to find everything. You just scroll down. Yeah. And this is places where all of my files are. And the default file manager is again Nemo for Gnome Flashback. Now, Gnome Flashback can actually be run on its, well, when you install Gnome Shell Extensions, this, you also get Gnome Flashback, but Gnome Flashback can also be run on its own without Gnome and without any other desktop. I didn't know this until I installed Debian, when I had the option during the install of installing Gnome Flashback, so I did, because it was a light desktop, and then I installed Cinnamon. But Gnome Flashback is also part of Cinnamon, because when you install the Cinnamon desktop, the Cinnamon desktop depends on either the Mate desktop and panel to run, or the Gnome Flashback desktop, because Cinnamon is very closely tied to Gnome. So if you uninstall the Mate on panel on Linux Mint, it automatically installs this, the Gnome Flashback desktop. This is Nemo, the file manager. But the default file manager is again Nautilus. Nautilus is also installed in here. But I've set Nemo as the default. Oh, I've noticed that all the folder colours that I've set in Nemo are showing in Nautilus, so it's copied all of the custom settings. And it has two panels. It has a panel at the top with all your applications, Gnome Flashback has, and a panel at the bottom, which, well, for example, when you open an application like this, then you minimize it, shows you the minimize window. And although Nemo's a default file manager, I don't think it's drawing the desktop icons. I think Nautilus is, because you've got a different right-click menu here. can change the background once again. Not bad, but how about this one? These are all Linux Mint wallpapers, and you do get lovely wallpapers in here. I'm going to go with this one, I think. And I've installed Menu Libre. Because a la carte doesn't seem to work very well in here. I don't know why. I think there's a bug in Ubuntu Jammy in this version of, you know, Linux Mint or whatever, because Menu Libre works better in here, and I can use this to add items to the menu. And I've installed a search thing called Synapse, which searches for everything, so I can search the menus. For example, if I want to run WaterFox, save having to scroll down the menu for it, it will just launch it here. If I want to run Paint, okay. And there's also another useful program. You can run commands without opening the terminal. No, not actual commands or update commands, but programs. For example, if I grun, this is called grun, and if I want to run, say, GNOME terminal, I can do that here. Oh, I spelt it wrong. Yeah. I'm going to open. This is the image viewer. So it's like the Windows run command. And I can also change the panel. You know, I can move it from the top to the bottom. I can move this panel down here if I want and have it at the bottom. But, and also the panel here, I can change this and move this to the left or the right or to the top. But I think it looks nice as it is, you know. I mean, I could have this panel on the bottom and have this on the top, but I think it looks nice as it is. And you know, when you open a program, it shows the windows here. This is settings. So all the settings are here. This is GNOME Control Center. And all of the settings are here, same as on GNOME. So this runs independently of GNOME. It doesn't need the main GNOME desktop to run. Startup applications. These are all the startup applications that run at startup. You can edit them or add them, add programs to the start to run when the system starts up. And to change the and if you're going to install Gnome Flashback as your only desktop, you still need to run Gnome Tweaks, not Gnome Shell Extensions. That won't run unless you've got Gnome installed as well. But use Gnome Tweaks to change the icons. And there's an icon theme I want to show you in here. I've installed the Zorin theme, which is nice. I'm going to show you it. A theme from Zorin OS. The icon theme, that is. There you are, now we have the Zorin OS theme with the icons, desktop icons, well, folder icons as well. And this is the icon theme from Zorin OS. Look, it's nice, isn't it? So, see, the theme is exactly how it looks on Zorin OS. I've run Zorin OS in live CD and it looks, well, the theme looks something like this anyway. And here you've got the date and the time. It shows you the date here. And you've got your sound settings and battery settings, you know, all in this panel here. And this is if you want to log on or log off. So, you know, this is a useful tool, Qt5 settings. If you're running a KDE application and the text is a bit small, you can adjust your text here and change the text and make it larger or smaller. So this is useful to have on here. This gets installed whenever you install a KDE application like Gwenview. Qt5 settings. We're going to tweaks again. I've also got the Pop! OS theme here. This is the icon theme from Pop! OS. Look. So this is the Pop! OS icon theme. And you see the start menu's changed. It's so you can change the theme by using Gnome Tweaks. And so has the Gnome Control Center theme changed. Well, now I'm going to log out of here and show you the Gnome Classic desktop. I'll just pause the video so I can do that. And I'm going to show you Gnome Classic. So this is Gnome Classic. This is Gnome Classic. I wonder if the terminal will tell us what it is. Well, we know what it is, but I'm just saying that oh, think it doesn't, but this is Gnome Classic. Now, this is really Gnome Shell Extension. It's not a desktop at all. And, well, you basically sort of have a similar menu to what you had in the main Gnome Desktop, which is this top menu here. And you've got this, and surprisingly it saved the icons, all the icons I put on the desktop in GNOME and GNOME Flashback, they're on here. I don't think you can add icons to the desktop, or can you? I'm not sure. Let's just see. Oh, you can. Oh, I'm surprised at that. What if I want to put VLC player on the desktop, can I? Oh, you just drag it to the desktop. I didn't know you could do that in here. Well, I thought in GNOME Classic you couldn't, but apparently you can. This is the Ubuntu dock. See, it's been ported over here. This is like, can you move the panel at all? No, I don't think you can actually move the panels. Or see, unlike GNOME Flashback, you cannot change the panel. The top panel stays up here. You can't move this top panel to the bottom or to the side, and you can't change any of the panels. They're just the top. The panels are just where they are. I mean, if you want to move the top panel to the bottom, you can't. And if you want to change this and move it to the bottom, you move this to the top. If you want to move this bottom panel to the top, you can't. So you can't change the panels or move or change the position of the panels. In GNOME Flashback, you could move the top panel to the bottom or to the side or to the left or the right, but on here you can't. You can't move the panels at all here. But you've got an application menu. See, this is other. This is what I use for the search. Synapse. And this is what I use for the run command, grun, but so it's got all the applications, and I suppose if I wanted to search, I'd just use this, which it'd still work, wouldn't it? Yeah, of course it does. But it doesn't have the search bar in the menu, and I can't really customize the menu. But everything works. So you could use this, so logging into GNOME Classic, if you didn't want GNOME Flashback, it's an option, isn't it? You can. What about changing the desktop background? Well, so it's using Nemo as its file manager here, isn't it? Because you can either choose not to have the desktop icons or choose to have the desktop icons, so it is using Nemo, whereas GNOME Flashback is using Nautilus to draw the desktop icons. But here it's using Nemo to draw the desktop icons, and you can still access things from the dock. We have our software center, there it is again. Can you still change the desktop background on here? That's the thing. Well, yep. You can. deconfiguration editor. Well, I mean, would Gnome Tweaks still work in here? Would, I think all the functions do work. Or do they? Yeah. Oh, so all the themes work, so you can use it as a desktop. It isn't, it's still an option, isn't it? But what if I wanted a plain background? But yep. I think I can change it. Let's see. What background will I have this time? I'm going to go for a sort of a this color. I just choose my color on here. And change it like this by putting the new color I want from the color picker on here, and then yeah, so all the functions still work on Gnome Classic. Oh yeah, so it is a fully functional desktop still. So I'm surprised at that. So yeah, so this is a Gnome Classic desktop. So yeah, so if you want to use this, this is an option, definitely. Yeah, so, well, that's it for now, and I hope you've enjoyed watching the video. So, you know, it's quite interesting that the features that come with GNOME, including GNOME Shell Extensions, you've even got another desktop, which is useful, isn't it, as well as GNOME Flashback, which can be run on its own, but GNOME Classic can't be run on its own, it's part of GNOME Shell Extension, but it's still another option if you don't like the default GNOME desktop, or if you just fancy a change, it's still nice, isn't it? Yeah, anyway, hope you enjoyed watching, and I'll see you again next time then. Bye.